Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I am continuing with the series of videos I'm doing about LangChain. I will introduce you Lancer. Lancer is a different packet of LangChain inside the same ecosystem of tools that you can use together with LangChain. It's a package that will help you to quickly and easily deploy RESTful APIs of your LangChain runnables or chains. This how it's done is doing in combination or under the hood. Lancer is using FastAPI and also PyDanti. FastAPI is a web framework which allows you to create essentially RESTful APIs or also as well application web applications, but it's more orientated to create RESTful APIs. And secondly, you have PyDanti. PyDanti is something that we already saw look at this several times in our videos in the channel, and this is the library which allow us to enforce the data types in Python. So today, as in other occasions, I will go through an example in Python, and I will show you something that I took from the Lancer repository. There is multiple examples, and I modified to create this video and also extend it to show you other functionalities that were not available in this example. The example is essentially a chatbot, a multi-user chatbot. You will see how easy it is create a ready-to-go application which is serving a bot, a conversational chatbot for which memory and with the capacity or ability to recognize the different users or multiple users. And then you will see as well, I will show you when we go through the notebook and also the code, you will see how easy is create an application using this library. And then the purpose for what I'm seeing of Lancer is help you know to quickly deploy and easily deploy an application, and it's practically ready to go with minimum code. And also focus in the functionality of your chain, in the use case, what you want to do, and put a little bit aside the complexity of creating web applications or RESTful APIs. So this package, it will be very good tool, a Swiss knife that you have to keep always in your toolkit, in the tools that you in your toolbox. Read it, or at least know that the library is there, because believe me, it will help you a lot. You will see here now on the video how easy it is to create an API, and not only that, how speed up the process of deploying a model or a LangChain component to production, including documentation and testing and everything. Okay, let's start. As usual, I will provide this notebook and also the code in the repository as we did in previous videos. So to install it is done simple to pip install lancer. If you want to install server side and client side, you just specify all. If not, you can just install lancer with brackets client or server. I install both because, well, in the video I will show you the different ways that you have to interact with the server. One is just simply using the SDK that they provide, so the client side, and the other one is just simply using request, no? You will see as well how to prepare the server side, and also how to create different entry points for different chains or serving different purposes. And again, The example is going through how to create or a RESTful API and an application which is serving a multi-user chatbot, conversational chatbot. So let's start. We go first of all to the server side. The server side, we just install. I'm going to shut down the server first of all. Later on we will install it again, we will run it again. Okay, we install the, or sea, we import the libraries we need. You may see that we are importing majoritarily LangChain components, and then we just import from Lancer Arroad. We will cover this down at the bottom of the script where we are adding the different entry points to the FastAPI applications. Also, we just import the necessary to build the application. A small note, this is one of the most complex examples I found in the documentation, and even I adapted to include additional, extended with additional functionality, and you will see how quickly you can deploy a prototype or something to show to your users and start to do testing. And spread or divide the testing of all the functionality that you want to try in practically in one day. You can have even probably less than that. One day you can have with the Lancer an application that is ready to be tested, and well, I wouldn't say deployed, but you will see as well how easy it is create documentation and many other things that you need to consider at the time that you want to deploy an application. You will be focusing in your functionality, in the functionality that you want to cover, and this is what you have to do it as well, but they are very well structured and easy to do, and only doing using the ad routes and well knowing some is other details how to, for example, provide the keys to the models, etc. But you will see how you just need to focus in the model, in the chain, and less focusing in how to create the application. This is the purpose of introducing Lancer. So what we do here, we import the libraries, we here load in memory the key to access the API of OpenAI and also Anthropic. We will look at the models of Anthropic, at least introduce you how to access the API. Here we are just checking if the LangChain is having the correct version. We are creating some helpers to the chat that we are going to create had memory, and also is able to identify the user. If you had multiple users interacting at the same time with the chatbot, with this code, we are creating some code, some logic to allow the user, allow the chatbot identify to which conversation belonged the chatbot is receiving via one of the entry points. To do that, what we do in the chatbot, we are creating an structure of folders where we keep the history, and then under the history the root of the where we are keeping the history of every user. We had a user folder, in this case we had two, and inside the folder we had the a file with the history of that user in that session. The session, as you see here, is an identifier, or session identifier, which I will show you how we build it. And then on, you can keep in a session. So a session means every time that you run the server or start the server, and then and you start to interact with the bot. Once you shut down the server, you can start a different session. And then you will see how having inside the same session, you have multiple users and the chatbot is able to identify them and interact correctly with both of them. This is something that we do with the keeping a tree like this, and also using the buffer memory capabilities that are available in LangChain. So with this code, we just creating the tree and all the necessary logic to keep the history and to interact with the chatbot, and also to provide the chatbot the right history belonging to the right user. This is something like creating cookies on persist your cookies in a folder in your file system, and this give us the ability to again to identify the right conversation for the right user and send this as a context to the chatbot to continue with the conversation with the right conversation and with the right topic, no? You will see that now we are doing this with the chatbot, but you can extend as well the chatbot with additional context. It's gonna be just simply interact with the chatbot without any additional vector database or RAG component, whatever. We just interact with a how to say raw chatbot with a model behind. It's gonna be Anthropic model or OpenAI model, and the purpose of the video will see that how you can do the interaction with one conversational chatbot from multiple users, and everything served in a very easy way and also very fast way of deploy the application. So here again, we create the infrastructure necessary to identify user and histories. We create here the application. Here we are just trying. We create some logic to avoid hijacking the session, no? Or sending queries or requests to the chatbot without user ID or session ID, and then you will receive a HTTP 400 if you don't have user ID or session ID. That's the way that also we had to inform the user that there is some values that are not available on your request. And one thing I want you to notice is that you can reuse this code that you are seeing here for any component that you want to deploy via a RESTful API with very small changes. You have here already with this probably 50, 100 line of code, you had already a multi-user chatbot, and then you can add to this chatbot as much as you want entry points with different functionalities. You will see now how easy now. Up to here, we just prepared the multi-user chatbot, and now we are going to define what the chatbot is gonna do. So now we are going to create a template here We are an assistant with the name bot. We just set up the message placeholder for the history and the input for the user or the human query. We create the chain, very simple chain, prompt and model. The model, remember that to load, to create an instance of ChatOpenAI this way, you had to have the memory the key loaded in memory, something like this. Either you export the key into memory with the export command in Unit or the set in Windows, or you do it like this. Here I have my keys on my data environment, and just I simply get the memory from, sorry, I get the key from the .env file, and I push the key to the environment variable. Open underscore API underscore key for OpenAI, and Anthropic underscore API underscore key for Anthropic models. So now we have here a chain, and we just create a pedantic clutch for the human input, which is essentially what we are going to send up as request. Here we create a runnable with message history. In this is the final object that we are going to use to be the chain that is going to interact with the user. And then this object contains the chain that we create here, which is the pronoun, the OpenAI, the buffer, and the configuration. And then on to create the entry point and fast API is done simple than this. As wrote, the fast API application, the chain, and the configuration in this case. If you don't specify path, this means that you are this application will be served in the roof of the application server. And then later on we will, if you do it this way, so by default AddRoads, which is a model, sorry, a method or function of the Lancer, come with some predefined entry points. We will see this in a second. Then on another way to create or other entry points that we are creating in this server is one that you can access via localhost or IP address / OpenAI. This is a chat OpenAI bot on the same application server. Here we had another one, but using chat Anthropic, and this will be served in localhost / Anthropic. And here we had a fourth one, so we have four models, four chains in the same application server. One is the general one, which is the chat conversational chatbot with history and multi-user capabilities. Here we had this is being served on the root of the application server. The other one is being served in / OpenAI, and this is a chatbot with OpenAI. This is no memory, no nothing. It's just a chatbot, which I want to show you how we will interact later on from the client side. The same for Anthropic, and there is a fourth entry point with another chatbot, which is as well a chatbot from Anthropic. The model that we use is Chat Anthropic, and we had a template that essentially a very simple tell me a joke, and here we receive as an input a topic. No, we add as well with our roads the under the folder or under the URI joke. So this means that this chatbot is listening in localhost / joke. And here just we run the server, and the server is going to listen in the port 8000 in the localhost IP address, and this is the application that we defined before. So here, as you see here, we simply add four different entry points, four different chat box in this listening in different addresses. And in the same IP address, no? So you can interact with four different models in how to say, and what I wanted to show you is how easy it was to deploy this. For those people that are watching this video that know how it works FAST API, they will understand how easy is create this. And then we just focus in very simple things. We just create here some logic to keep the history. And again, you can replicate this for any other component that you want to create that had a multi that that you need multi-user and keep the history. And then we create the change and we add the change to a location into our application server. And that's all. 216 lines of code, and together with comments, probably we had less than 200, and we have here four chat box running in the same server. Now we are going to interact with them, and you will see. I will show you as well some other topic for those that are also familiar with testing and deploying applications to production. How helpful is to use Lancer at the time to deploy an application. We run the server, and now your Lancer is serving on, is ready to and listening for a request on the port 8000. So let's go to the client. So to interact with the client side, we need to import the remote root enable. This is the client to interact with LAN server, with the server side or LAN server. And we import UUID to create a conversation ID, no? So to interact now with the remote root enable, we just pass the URL, our local host, this is the server URL, and we pass cookies, our user ID. You can write here whatever. I will show you. This is to just create a user. You can pass whatever you want. And then the conversation ID is just a random ID. UID, UUID is one library that allows you to create random IDs. There is multiple size, multiple formats that you can create ID with the same library. This is one of them. So this is not is irrelevant for what we are seeing here. So and now, if you want to invoke the chat, remember that what I told you in the roof is working the multi-user chatbot, with memory. Okay, and then how we are going to check? Okay, we send in the human input variable. My name is Olonok, and the parameter configurable is the conversation ID. Okay, this is what we define in the logic where we keep track of the history and the users. And then, so this is the user ID once we interact and the user is all or not. So we invoke the user. So my name is all or not. Sorry, hello, Olonot. My name is Bot. How can I assist you? Here you see who is answering us is a OpenAI model. And now remember, this is F733. If you go to the model A733, so in chat histories, Olonot, we have created already a JSON file with everything, the model, and you need to keep the conversation. Now we return to the chat. We are going to do another question. What's my name? So I want to you, yeah. And then your name is Solonop, yeah. And it's the same model. So how we invoke here, we are just sending the same conversation ID and the model remember that is my name. I don't need to send here anything more. Okay, now we create another client, and then this time we say the name pájaro, whatever, is just a name. And then on, I'm asking in Spanish, what is my name? And obviously, the model doesn't know what is my name. Hola. Te llamas what? Okay, that is, he doesn't know how it knows. Then what I want to show you is here, for the same ID, is creating the history. Okay. And now let's return to the code. We ask something. And I ask in the days of the week in German. Yeah. Okay, so we had two different conversations. This is the check ID, and then this is just check where you had the files, and then on you can look at the history of user Olonok. What's your name? What's my name? All or not. And now we do the same with the user pájaro. Hola. Here, this is grown, but it's not mixing the conversation with the user all or not. Okay? And then you see with a simple 200 lines of code from the server, we have a conversational chatbot. You can extend it now with a RAG component and specialize the chatbot with some topic about the medicine, about the repairing cars, whatever. And then you can deploy this to two users, test it, and many other things in practically less than one day. So that's what I tried to explain or to show you, that how easy is create an application ready to go. You need to focus on your functionality and what you want to provide to the user and create a chain, an appropriate chain, and then only just introducing this chain into the server, plug this chain to a route into the application server and start to test. One thing I want to show you as well before we continue is what I explained you before. If you go to localhost 800, which is the application server, and you just write /docs, you have all the documentation OT that allow you to interact with this application server. And then for those that are familiar with FAST API, with testing, with deploying application, you will understand that to do this is a matter of weeks. So here you had, for example, you want to interact with the Anthropic entry point. And here you had what you need, which parameters you need to send, what is the code in order to, what you are going to receive a response. You can write and you received everything, you had everything documented. So this is really speeding up a lot the deployment of applications. You have here, for example, everything is only doing add roads with your chain in your application, and a couple of more parameters, as you can see here on the code. For example, let's look at Chaton OpenAI, this one. This is code, application, Chat OpenAI, the model, and the path where it's going to be served. No? We look at what is being generated, OpenAI config and OpenAI. All these things has been created automatically by Lancer. And again, for those that are involved on the operational process of deploying a model and AI application to production, they will appreciate really what this really means. For example, you want to invoke the chat, no? So it's telling you which parameters you need and a string, the default value config has. So how you had to build the body of your request. What do you expect? We can try this as well, and you will see that we are not going to send anything. You can try out, and if you try it, the conf this is empty, and then supposedly we receive a code. We are invoking, and this is what we are receiving for the world. So this allows you to test the application, to create all the unit tests, everything that you need. Everything is documented. You can share this with other developers, with other engineers, with the users, to understand how they can interact with your application. And again, you don't need to do it. It's a Lancer is doing everything for you. And this will help you to just focus in the functionality that you want to add to the Lancer with using LangChain, because the rest is done for you. Let's check it. It's exactly the what I wanted to show you is in the default, no? The default here, exactly. We need to send, you see here, this is the root entry point. This is the multi-user chatbot with memory. So you remember, we need to send a config object with the conversation ID and the user ID. So if we try this entry point, we will receive what is expected, execute. True. So now it's taking one of the models from one of the users from memory. Well, again, no user phone, exactly. You see here, what we received, error, bad request, the type no user ID found. Why? Because we didn't specify one in the user ID. So again, probably I'm insisting too much, but again, for people who is to deploy an application, you see how easy is to do it with Lancer. It's really well done, and believe me, speeding up a lot the deployment of applications into production. Not only deploying, also testing, providing access to users in your environment to fully test all the entry points. And again, just doing with some lines of code, 3-5 lines of code, just to create the entry points, multiple entry points. Like here, you can do streaming, stream lock, stream events. So All this is created automatically with the arrowed method. Okay, let's continue with the exercise. Now we are going to create also objects to use remote runable. This is clients to use the other entry points. So here, remember, we had the OpenAI entry, Anthropic and Joke. This is these three, OpenAI, Anthropic, and the Joke, which is the model, but with a chat prompt which tell the model to create jokes about a topic. Here it's just, well, a raw model. You can just interact with this via prompt as well, but the prompt you have to create it in the input that you, so this is, you can create on your input, send the context to the model, and in the prompt that you send, or in the human message, you can create the context and ask the model what you want to receive from the model. And here you are just indicating what with a template what this chain is gonna do. And again, all of them, one is in under OpenAI, localhost OpenAI, localhost Anthropic, and localhost Joke. We return to the code. So we here create three clients, one per entry point, and here we just call the joke. We send topic parrots. Why we send topic parrots? Because if you remember, here we have a variable with this topic. Let me check here. Tag. So we call the joke. And again, now we do the same. We do the same with Anthropic string. If you remember what I showed you, just creating this add route, creating the this using this model here. We not only create one entry point, we create in total all these variants. No, you go to Anthropic here. You had the schemas, input, output, config schema in both batch string. You had as well, we are going to use this now. Okay, and what you need, and then we use here, we send a prompt, human message, at like either a cat or a parrot. No, this is, and then you are saying just hello, and then using a string, you are going to receive a number of messages. And then check it out. Content, oops. So it's just doing silly things, no? Now we use here another object, which is simply send this. Tell me a long story about a topic, and then we use the runable math, and we send the same to these two entry points. One is OpenAI and the other one is Anthropic. So you remember there are these two entry points we have, which are essentially the model itself, and you are sending everything, all information you need in the prompt. So we send the same to chat OpenAI that what we send to Anthropic. Let's return to the code, and then on we ask a long story about parrots and a long story about cats. So what we are doing here, we just use the chain batch, and then again you can go here to batch, Too much. Here you have inanthropic. It's describing you how you can use it. And you can go as well to OpenAI. And you had your batch here. And use it again. Now, so with the runnable mode, we are just going to map the chain to these two different models. And then with the batch, we will send these two topics to these two models. We just execute this here. And you will see here OpenAI and Anthropic. This is for the topic Parrot. This is here a long story about Parrot. And here we have the second. This is OpenAI for cats. And here you have Anthropic. So what is allow you to do this? For example, to test your model, these two models, with the same input and see which one adapt better to the functionality that you want to create. Let's imagine that this is a very simple thing, but you have here a conversational chatbot that is specialized in attend clients to that are asking for information about your orders, no, in your company. You can quickly deploy two models, okay, and create the change create two chains with two different models and ask different questions to these two models. And this way, later on, you can compare which one is providing the best answer, or the most suitable, or the closest one to the expected answer. And finally, I'll show you how you don't need to use the runnable, remote runnable class, the client Outlancer. You can just simply send a request. Looking at the documentation that is provided in Lancer, that automatically answer, you just look how to invoke the entry point. In this case, we are going to invoke the entry point joke, and we just say as a JSON object the topic about taxi drivers. So okay, fantastic. So that's all. I hope that you like it. Really interesting topic. I really recommend you just to take a look and keep it in mind when you want to test your chains and whatever you are creating. This is really helping you a lot at the time that, especially testing multiple alternatives, testing with getting the feedback from multiple users in your organization before you deploy the final version to production. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like it and you find it illustrative and helpful, and that's all. Thank you very much. Give me a like if you enjoy with the video, and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you. Bye bye.